much of that.
But it is a power play. That's good news as far as getting the game over with.
The other good news is there's lots of room on the bench.
There's Walker. He doesn't mind getting into it. He's trying right there. Walker banging away. Another shove. He wants a fight. He was still after it at the other end. Now Robitaille goes after him, and here we go again.
Look at this. Now you got to move Robitaille into it. You know what? You had to know this was going to happen, and Dave Jackson let Walker hit and hit and hit from behind, and that's why we've got what we have here. You had to know what kind of game this was. You had to take him off.
And you knew that Robitaille was going to stick up for his teammates.
Tomas Holmstrom was the man that Bickoff wanted to go with, and Holmstrom kept trying to skate away, and then Robitaille came in to stand up for Holmstrom.
Come on, the MO was the same on this shift as it was on the last shift. And you got to call it. That was Dave Jackson's hand. Come on.
I can't disagree with you at all, Bill. You're absolutely right. Walker was being very aggressive on the play, and Robitaille wasn't going to take it anymore. Then he got double teamed.
I mean, the MO has been established here, folks.
This is dragging out, guys.
We just got barely enough players left to finish this game. Only got 35 seconds left to go. Hull has had three goals.
Still don't want to break up.
Still don't want to break up.
Luke Robitaille skating off, boy. It looks like he's holding his right hand down by his side.
I think he took one for his team. I really do.
Sure he did. Meanwhile.
Oh, look at this. A chair just got thrown on the ice by Dave Lewis. He just threw a chair. It's sitting right in center ice. They got to break this thing up. This is crazy. These guys are nuts. They're going to end up with suspensions and everything else. This is out of control.
There'll be fines and suspensions. Joey Koser apparently threw that chair. Koser's arguing with the St. Louis bench now.
Look at him.
If there's one guy on both teams I wouldn't want to scrap, Joe Koser. I'd go with any player. I won't go with Joe Koser. I'll tell you that right now.
But Joe Koser is seeing what I saw, and that is the St. Louis Blues have just come out and gone after the Red Wings the way it used to be done years ago.
Challenging the bench over there. He's talking to Joel Quenneville.
And Quenneville's saying that a stick came up and there was a cross check.
That's Quenneville and Joey Koser.
Joel Quenneville was a defensive defenseman. Joe Koser, this man, was an enforcer.
At one time, the heavyweight of the league. He had one of the biggest right hands I ever saw.
He's probably going to get a suspension. He's not going to get away with
throwing that chair. His wallet will be a little lighter.
You think he is, Bobby Knight? 35 seconds. Boy, that's the way he played. Same kind of fire. They picked the chair up. And I'm not kidding. We've just barely got enough guys left. A lot of the penalties here, they sent people to the dressing room with those fights because there's only 35 seconds left in the game.
This is the axe. See Walker going at it.
With Holmstrom.
Yeah, he just kept going, going, going right there again and again.
Another one. So Robitaille comes over. You'll see Robitaille come over. Oh, and he threw the cross check there first after Walker threw about 9 hits on Holmstrom. I think Robitaille took one for the team.
Sure he did. Oh, you bet he did.
I mean, Walker wanted it in the worst way, and Holmstrom wouldn't go with it.
Don't think that his teammates won't think a lot of him because of that. I mean,
as silly this is, when Robitaille was about to be hit, guys, he saw. Oh, look at him, he's still throwing. When Robitaille was going at it with Walker, Robitaille saw Doug Weight coming, and Robitaille threw an elbow up that got Doug Weight right in the face. And remember, Doug Weight's coming back from a fracture to the face. I mean, that's all these guys need is something stupid and a bad injury this time of the season when the playoffs are around the corner. It's goofy.
Well, while we have a moment, we'll tell you. Hull's had 3 goals and an assist. Datsyuk 1 and 3. Zetterberg 2 assists. Lidstrom, Fedorov, the other goals for Detroit. For the St. Louis Blues, not much there. Pronger and Nash have had the goals, and it's going to be a series sweep, first time in 36 years. Either team has swept the other in the regular season. The win's going to go to Manny Legacy in net. It'll be his 14th win of the year. And Osgood, again, unable to beat Detroit, and it's not just him. He'll be 0-4-1 against his former team, the Red Wings.
The Blues had a tough game, not last Saturday when Detroit was here, last Sunday, the day after, when they went into Dallas, and that was a really rough hockey game too.
That was Paul Boyer, the equipment manager for the Detroit Red Wings, literally carrying the equipment. This is where the NHL might want to consider giving the refs the option of just saying, okay, the last 35 seconds go into the record
game book, over.
Game over. We're out of here.
Goofy.
You know,
it's goofy. I agree.
We've had 161 penalty minutes before the penalties that are now being called. 161. And there are going to be a bunch more here, so it'll be well over that. And you can see the look at the benches. There's nobody there.
There are 8 skaters left for the Blues. 4, 6, 8, and 9 left for Detroit. 8 and 9.
Drop the puck, get it over with.
Still a 5 on.